Today we'll discuss about the another factor which is contributing for the fiber loss. So far we discussed about the attenuation in terms of absorption and scattering losses. Two types of absorptions we have seen there, extrinsic and intrinsic. Then in scattering loss, we came across linear and non-linear, and thereafter we gone through the study of this loss with respect to different types of optical fibers like multimode graded index, multimode single index, single mode, index fiber. So these are all inherent losses that we have studied, which are actually based on like in case of dispersion or absorption or scattering or dispersion. All these are different forms of the things which are contributing for the losses inherently to the optical fiber. Inherently, because either they depends on the characteristic features of the optical fiber, mainly due to the material they are using or manufacturing process, or it may be attributed to the optical rays or pulses, that the pulse spreading behavior what you have seen in the last few classes. Apart from these inherent things, there are some external things which are visible to the bare eyes, like when we want to connect two optical fibers, because we know that if you look at the core diameter and the dimensions, shapes and sizes, which are very small and delicate. And if at all, if you want to connect, because it is not possible to manufacture kilometers of length optical fiber all the way. We have to connect the optical fibers if you want to have the long length optical fibers, or if you want to divert the direction of the optical fibers in some of the directions. So connection of optical fibers is must. So whenever it is required to interconnect the two ends of the optical fibers, we are going to call that portion as a joint, optical joint. So these joints, again, there are two types, as it is visible on the screen. Here you can see. So splices and connectors. Splices are nothing but permanent joints or semi-permanent joints, which are similar to the electrical soldering what you're doing, which are either permanent or semi-permanent. Mostly used in the telecommunication systems. And these are known as, such kind of joints are known as splices. Suppose if your joint, fiber joint is not permanent, it can be removed at any time, it can be formed, it can be used to form the joint at any time. Means it can be coupled and decoupled at any moment. It is similar to the electrical plugs and sockets. Such kind of demountable fiber connectors are known as a connectors. Mm-hmm. So like that, we got two types of joints, splices, which are either permanent or semi-permanent joints, and demountable fiber connectors, which can be joined, coupled or decoupled at any moment, like which are analogous to electrical plugs and sockets. So the when we are going to join two ends of the optical fibers, either by using the splices or connectors, or then some portion of the light may be reflected back or transmitting from which it is coming. So that is known as a Fresnel reflection. So this is very important phenomena that is occurring whenever you go for joining two ends of the optical fibers. This is very important. So this reflection is occurring because there is sudden change in the refractive index at the joint. Because you can see here, you are go whenever we want to join the two ends, we want the two ends to be similar or same. Their core indices or cladding indices and the two fibers should be same. Their characteristics should be same. And when you want to join the two ends, there should be some mismatch. Mismatch in the indices. Because of this sudden change in the refractive indices at the place where the joining is happening, we'll get this Fresnel reflection. For example, suppose if you are joining two glass fiber ends with air as a medium between those two fiber ends, the joint place will be air. So air refractive index will be different than the refractive index of the glass. There will be a sudden change in the refractive index at this glass air interface. Because of this, we'll be getting this Fresnel reflection. So this partial reflection of light transmitted through the interface, and it can be estimated by the classical Fresnel formula, that is a amount of partial reflected light, that is R, that is given by that it depends on the core refractive index and the refractive index of the medium where this joining is happening. Normally it is here, nowadays we are seeing at present. So N will be 1. So it will be decided by this formula, the fraction of light, the amount of light that is reflected back is given by R equal to N on minus N by N on plus N to the whole square. And the same thing in decibels, this loss, because of this reflection, Fresnel reflection, the amount of loss what we are encountering in terms of decibels, it is given at the interface is given by minus 10 log to the base 10 of 1 minus R. R is a fraction of the reflected light at single interface. Means it is reflected and moving in one direction. Okay, not in both the directions. That's what is called single interface. So it is clear that Fresnel reflection gives a significant loss, more amount of loss at a fiber joint. E1 will consider all the things or conditions are ideal at the connection point. But this loss can be significantly reduced by using index matching fluid in the gap where joint is happening. No, the gap is happening. If you are going to fill up that gap by using index matching fluid, Is the fluid having the same refractive index as that of the either of the core? In theory, it can be reduced, but practically, how much it is possible, we don't know. That is beyond the scope. In theory, he is telling Fresnel reflection can be significantly reduced in theory, eradicated, but practically, it can be tested. So this is all about the fiber alignment and the joint loss. Let us see some mathematical aspects. We'll take the help of some mathematical problem here. An optical fiber has a core refractive index, as given. Core refractive index means now he has given N1, this one. N1 is given. Two lengths of the fiber with a smooth and perpendicular end faces are butted together. Butted means joined together. Another word they are using technical terms in optical domain. One having the smooth end, another one having the perpendicular end. T joint, maybe they want to join, don't they want to form. Assuming the fiber axis are perfectly aligned. Perfectly aligned, they perfectly positioned with each other, with their mouth horizontally facing each other like that. That is called alignment. Their alignment is perfect. Calculate the optical loss in decibels at the joint when there is small air gap. So what do you mean by small air gap? Small air gap is there at the in the gap. Means there is no any index matching fluid in the gap. Okay, now we can do that one by using R. We have to find out first. Loss in dB is calculating minus 10 log of to the base 10 of 1 minus R is there. First, you have to find out the R. R is nothing but the fraction of the reflected light. That is N1 minus N by N plus N. N1 is given. That is 1.5 minus N. What is N? N is the refractive index of the medium in the place where the jointing is happening. That is here is there. That is 1. You substitute and calculate, you will get it as R as 1.04, or it is a 4%. Only 4% of the light will be reflected back. If you substitute that R as a 0.04 in this formula, loss in the terms of decibels, minus 10 log to the base 10 of 1 minus R, that is 1 minus 0.04, will get log to the base 10 of 0.06. You will get it as 0.18 dB. Means loss with the 4% transmitted light, I am incurring 0.18 dB decibels of loss. Okay, that is with a single interface. If you consider both the directions the reflection is happening, left and right side, then it will be twice 0.36 decibels. So this, guys, you have to remember. Symmetry is clear. Here you can see. Here it is one-sided means it is 1.18 dB. If it is two-sided means symmetrical means 0.36 dB. This is very important. So this one is a very important point. I want you to focus on this. So there are three possible types of misalignments are there. Like if you look at this figure, so clearly, if you want, you can zoom your screens. The first one you can see, two fiber ends are separated by a distance Z longitudinally. They are separated. Even though you formed the joint, but some gap will be left out there. That is called longitudinal misalignment. Lateral misalignment is like that. Laterally, they are displaced, two ends. laterally they are displaced, got together by a distance of amount of y. This also known as a radial displacement, lateral or radial misalignment. And this one you can see, of course the joint has been found successfully, but there is some angular deformation, angular misalignment. Like that we got three types: one, longitudinal misalignment; second one, radial or lateral misalignment; and third one is angular misalignment. If you look at their CAD6 in this figure, this figure shows the CAD6 of the longitudinal, you can see here, longitudinal and lateral misalignment, and how much loss is occurring, that we are going to study here. It is clear from this graph, they did some experiment on understanding the behavior of this longitudinal and lateral misalignment and how much loss it can incur, and they got some readings and plotted the graph. It is very much clear from this graph, sorry. The insertion loss, for example, if you take a displacement of around 10 decibels, okay, 10 decibels of displacement. If you look at this one, lateral misalignment will give you around 1 decibels of insertion loss compared to longitudinal, which is around very much less, that is 0.01 or maybe 0.1 decibels, very much less. Like that, if you go like this with increasing displacement, the longitudinal misalignment will incur less insertion loss compared to the lateral misalignment. Lateral misalignment is, you can see, a sudden peak rise, or we are getting insertion loss compared to the longitudinal. Means, in this type of longitudinal misalignment, the loss is less compared to the lateral. That's what he is showing here. Similarly, the third one, angular misalignment. With the ear as a gap, having the numerical aperture 0.22, you can see the insertion loss is slowly increasing. Suppose if you fill up that gap with some index matching fluid, okay, with the maintain the same numerical aperture of 0.22, you can see suddenly the insertion loss will be got increased. This is very important, guys. We cannot use, if you use index matching fluid in order to minimize that joint loss or Fresnel reflection in case of angular misalignment, it will significantly enhance your insertion loss instead of reducing it. Okay, so that is very important. So that's why, so this you should be careful whether to use or not in case of angular misalignment, to use the index matching fluid. Because normally for telecommunication purposes, we are using small core diameter optical fibers, which are core diameter having less than 150 micrometer, and will normally suffer from Fresnel reflection in both directions to interfaces. Therefore, angular misalignment and lateral will cause significant insertion loss compared to the longitudinal. That's what we are concluding. So what is the conclusion? As far as the misalignment types are concerned, angular and lateral misalignments will cause significant insertion losses. That too should be careful if you are using index matching fluid in case of angular misalignment. And longitudinal misalignment will give you a very much reduced insertion loss or Fresnel reflection. Okay. So this is one the conclusion or observation of what you are making when you're going to study these things. So let us continue the journey with respect to multimode fiber joint. We'll get two. We are going to discuss these one. Those are the three types we just now discussed: longitudinal, lateral, and angular misalignment. How they are going to affect the joints? Let us look at the jo joints. How they are going to behave with respect to multimode fibers and single mode fibers like that. So lateral misalignment. You can see that what we have concluded will be giving you less insertion loss. That we are going to continue. That technology we are using, lateral misalignment, because that will give you less insertion loss compared to the longitudinal and angular misalignment. Assuming uniform excitation, yes, if you assume uniform excitation of all modes, because that is important, practically that will not happen because all modes will be excited at different times, having their different propagation, incident angles, incident times, and propagation delay paths. That is in modal dispersion, intermodal dispersion are obviously they are going to occur. But to keep the mathematical discussion simple, will make assumption that they're all excited at the same time. In the multimode step index fiber, we are considering the case of multimode, that is step index fiber. The overlapped area between the both fiber cores having the lateral coupling efficiency is, that is a zeta lateral is given by this formula. You have to remember this, no derivation as such, but you have to remember this formula. A very long formula is there. You have to remember it because widely we are using it. And remember, we'll be getting a lot of numericals to deal with on module 2 in VT question papers. Such problems I will be taking here. And it is a must and should that you have to remember such formulas. You have to practice them, write down them, and practice them. Remember the formulas correctly. If you miss either square to the power 4 or inversion or to the power of 1 by 2 or any one of the bracket or any one term or two or any term, then your whole effort will be lost. The problems are very simple, straightforward. You have to understand it. What is the problem? What is the given data? You have to apply the formula correctly with all the terms correctly. Simply, you have to know how to use the calculator. Your job is done. Because it is very simple to score more by attempting numericals in less time compared to the theoretical questions. That is my suggestion. Even I will insist. So if you look at this formula, N1 and N, we already know N1 is the core index, N is the index of the media there where the joint is forming, and Y is the lateral offset of the fiber core axis. Lateral offset, and A is the fiber core radius, and minus 10 log to the base 10 of this if we get, will give you the loss because of the lateral misalignment in terms of decibels. Let us take an example here. A step index fiber, he is taking the step index. Of course, settings is multimode. Step index is there. So we'll be taking the step index fiber as the RI of 1.5. That is N1. Core diameter 50 micrometer. Means A is given, 2A is given, 50 micrometer, A will be 25. The fiber is jointed with the lateral misalignment. Lateral misalignment, remember, we are using lateral misalignment because it will give the less insertion loss. Between the core axis of 5 micrometer. Okay. Why is lateral offset will be 5 micrometer? This one is asking you to estimate insertion loss at the joint Due to lateral misalignment, assuming uniform distribution of power among all guided modes, means they are excited at the same time. That is assumption. There is a small air gap. Then in that case, n will be 1. So it will become 16 n1. N1 is 1.5 divided by n, means that is the air we are using. That is the first a bit. Small air gap will be there. That is 1. 1.5 by 1 will be 1. Oh, sorry, 1.5 divided by into bracket 1 plus 1.5 by 1, that is 1.5 to the power 4 to cos inverse y. Lateral offset will be 5 micrometer divided by 2a, the core diameter 50 micrometer minus y by a. A will be half of 2a, that is 25. Like that, if you substitute and solve it, you will get around 0.804. Then take the logarithm of that, you will get the loss in terms of decibel, that is a 0.95 dB. Similarly, next he is asking, the joint is considered to be index matched instead of air. Suppose if you are using index matching fluid. Okay. Index matching fluid iddaga. So this term will not come. So this term will be there when the air is index matching. Other than air, if you have anything, suppose if it is index match, if it is telling, the first term is not coming. It directly start with the formula 1 by pi, like this, approximately. Then substitute all the things, we'll get it as 0.872, slightly increased. And the loss you will be getting 0.59 dB, it will be reduced. So with the index matching, the insertion loss will be reduced from 0.95 to 0.59 decibels. So this is the alternate way that we are going to calculate the loss. Let us consider a graded index fiber having parabolic refractive index profile alpha equal to 2. Idhu mean whenever you will be having graded index fiber having parabolic refractive index profile, means parabolic path under it is assumed that alpha equal to 2 and a core diameter 50. Estimate insertion loss due to 3 micrometer lateral misalignment, lateral shift. So for the graded index fiber with a parabolic reflection refractive index profile, there is a uniform elimination of all guided modes. You have to use this formula LT equal to 0.85 y by a. Y is the lateral offset 3 micrometer divided by a, the radius of the core, that is a 25, half of the diameter. Then coupling efficiency is given by 1 minus LT, that is 0.898. And take the logarithm of that will give the insertion loss due to lateral misalignment for the graded index fiber having parabolic index profile. That is, you will be getting it around 0.47 decibels. Second bit, when the uniform elimination of all guidance with the leaky modes will be there. Leaky modes means all modes are not excited at the same time. Okay, some modes will be leaked away or we are losing some information because of the delay in the modes. For that, the formula is this one. 0.85 by y by a for the uniform elimination with no leaky. With leaky, it will be 0.75. Take 1 minus of that will give the coupling efficiency. Take the decibel of that will give the insertion loss in terms of decibels. So here we'll wind up. Here your problem is over. So this is how some of the formulas we are enlisting along with the numericals that you have to remember. So angular misalignment losses at joints can be computed by using this formula where theta is there and delta will be giving you the relative index difference. Let us take an example you can understand. Two multimode step index fibers have numerical apertures 0.2, 0.4. Okay. रिस्पेक्टिवली एंड बोथ हैव द सेम कोर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ 1.48 N1. इंसर्शन लॉस एट द जॉइंट इन ईच फाइबर कॉज्ड बाय 5 डिग्री एंगुलर मिसअलाइनमेंट दैट इज थीटा इज गिवन. इट मे बी अज्यूम्ड दैट द मीडियम बिटवीन द फाइबर्स इज हियर. नो इंडेक्स मैचिंग फ्लूइड विल बी देयर. हियर इज देयर. N will be 1. So we know we have to use this formula to find out the angular coupling efficiency because of the angular misalignment. N1 is given, N is given, theta is given, delta we have to find out. That we can get by using the given numerical aperture. So two numerical apertures are given, we will get two solutions. Which one with respective numerical apertures given 0.2 and 0.4. We know the relationship between the numerical aperture and the given relative index difference. N1 is known, delta NA is given, you can find out the delta. Okay. You can substitute and find out the losses. For numerical aperture 0.2 will be getting 0.98 dB. And for numerical aperture 0.4, you will be getting it reduced to 0.862 decibels. So it is clear from the formula that the insertion loss due to angular misalignment is reduced by using the fibers with larger numerical apertures. Because the one problem we have seen that if you use fluid, index matching fluid, it is going to enhance the insertion loss. To cope up with that problem, to avoid that problem, instead we are using large numerical aperture fibers so that it can be used to reduce the misalignment and help in the forming the joint. So this is all about multi-mode joints. In single mode joint fibers, misalignment loss in case of single mode fiber in absence of angular misalignment, no theta is there, so there is no any angular misalignment, is given by 2.17 into y by omega whole square, where omega is the normalized spot size of fundamental mode. That is given by this formula. Again, omega equal to a into bracket 0.65 plus 1.62 v to the power minus 3 by 2 plus 2.8 v to the power minus 6 divided by square root of 2. And the single mode fiber, the insertion loss t is caused by angular misalignment theta. This is misalignment without angular. This is the loss not due to angular misalignment. And this is the loss with the angular misalignment. If you look at this problem, a single mode fiber has the following parameters. Normalized frequency V is given 2.40. Core refractive index N1 is given 1.46. Core diameter 2A 8 micrometer is given. Numerical aperture NA 0.1 is given. Estimate the total insertion loss of the fiber joint with a lateral misalignment of 1 micrometer, lateral offset 1 micrometer, and angular misalignment, that is theta 1 degree. So initially we have to find out this omega. Substituting the value of V, it just depends on the V value. 2.40 you can substitute. We get the omega as 3.12 micrometer. Then loss due to lateral offset will be given by 2.17 y by omega without considering the angular misalignment. With the angular misalignment, this formula. So if you add these two, lateral and angular offsets, will give the total loss, and take the logarithm of that will give the total loss in terms of decibels. Like that, in the similar respect, we have got another problem. Two single mode fibers with mode fill diameters 9.2 and 8.4 micrometer. Okay, this will be the intrinsic loss formula. Omega 02 and omega 01 are given. You can substitute them, you directly get the solution. So omega 02, omega 01 are half of these two mode fill diameters. Omega 02 is half of 8.4, that is 4.2. Omega 01 is half of 9.2, that is 5.6. So we'll stop here.